It's time for our tale of the tape. Dalton. Dalton Thunders. George G-Force Davey. And this is a fighter you certainly want to keep your eyes on as he has a bright future.
Oh, pure bad blood.
And with that, we turn it over to the world-renowned ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
This bout is scheduled for 12.
What a pleasure it is to be here in this... Let's I host for this battle between these two athletes. No rest for the weary.
To an arena and be the hero, the pressure, the expectation, the desire from the fans. You can't get away from it. Ignore them. Lock it up. I know it's hard. I can hardly hear you, Todd. You've got to ignore them. Get on with your job.
He misses with that jab.
Exchange here from both men.
Totally impressed. You know what? You've got skill. Oh, my goodness. I admire these guys.
And he just missed with that left jab. Timing beats speed. Speed beats power. Nice job landing that left counterpunch. Shot land. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. And time! Talking about slick.
I love that.
At this point, you got it. Here we go for round two. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on you. And that's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
And he fails to score with that left hook. Punch, counter punch. Misses with that jab. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
Counterpunch. Just a moment. Both of these men showing exceptional. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. Great counterpunching for both these athletes. Talking about Smith.
He's absolutely knocking, man. He's knocking.
Bell rings and we start the third. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. He misses with that jab. Don't just look at the head punches, though. Look at the body shots. That could be the real difference.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take that by a simple jab. It can be intimidating. It just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
He just misses with that jab.
Skill for skill, tap for tap, just like a match made in heaven.
The old adage is, no matter how much speed you've got, timing beats speed.
Let me explain to you about a fast fighter that's got hand speed and footwork. They relax, they're confident, they know they just have to put their boom. In a split second, they get four shots go. Their footwork has got them out of the way. These guys are so relaxed. Why they can maintain this all the way to a fight.
Counter shot with the right hand. Left punch. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Left counter was perfectly timed. Here's the bell to start round four. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Not an issue for this fighter who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, that knockout punch, they won't even shoot you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful.
Good counter punching for both these fighters. Nice exchange here from both men. Punch the score. If you throw out a lazy jab in this fight, you're gonna get knocked out. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, thinking, you just gotta be smart, man. You've gotta be like a little favorite, a pig.
Avoided catastrophe there. Nice counter. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left.
Hey, man!
Let's talk about Smith.
He's gone. I'm telling you, he's gone.
Here's the bell to start round five. Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here.
My motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An expert last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
That one will count.
One of these fights.
Why weren't they covering up?
like that round. Does that feel good?
Here we go in the sixth round. You couldn't finish him off in the last round. Let's see what this has in store for us.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not going to happen. He's got a piss on him. He's got a bluff.
He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here. There's a counter shot. Nice counter shot. Beautiful counter punch. Nice counter shot. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
To score with a jab. George Davey just got wobbled.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Push it up, get over the jab.
Hold work, that's it.
Breathe. There's the bell for round seven. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
The
referee's paused the action and we'll take a look at that cut.
Okay, are you all right? Are you okay?
A little bit of a surprise here as the referee says we can continue. One of these fighters certainly has a significant advantage. You can tell who it is.
You've got to ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable. Drag them. Get them complaining to the referee. Because once someone with excellent foot speed and excellent power gets into a rhythm, the fight is over.
No stamina, no injury, but still throwing punches. Changes everything, especially in this division. There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
I've seen some fighters with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like a crisp. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this is the dangerous part.
Attributes to have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. The corner's got the towel. Are they going to throw it in?
Man, I heard that never by soul.
Let's talk about
Smith.
Look,
he's absolutely knackered, man.
He's
knackered. He's gone. Just keep on top of it.
Let's go.
There's the bell to start round eight. Because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to to who's in better shape.
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hope to knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. Because you know what you can do in the gym, you can do it in a fight. You've got to relax.
Just a moment. Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill. Tap for tap. Now, this fight will say, you know what, I'm that notch above you, so I've got to respect Golden Boy more than happy.
You've got someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses. How do you deal with it?
This can be so frustrating. You're in such a fast fighter that can throw three full shot combinations before you even let one off.
Neck percentages have to be off the charts. Didn't wait long to get back and get engaged. Catch and shoot. Very close round with 10 seconds to go.
Good round.
The cut man's got some work to do in this corner. My concern is the corner. Are they going to be too brave for the fighter?
Great round. Relax.
This fighter's starting to get tired as we start round 9. What a round we just saw. Let's see what we've got in store for us here.
How much energy did they use? How hard and how tough and how much they had to dig deep? This is just ridiculous. I don't know what to expect. I'm tired just watching.
Can it get any better? What a round we just saw. Don't just look at the head punches they throw. Look at the body shots. That could be the real difference.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
So close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
Parries that left jab away. The jab not quite. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Off the charts action from both of these fighters.
Great work. I love that. That jab's slick. Such a hand. And every time you see him, take a big deep breath.
He's made it to round 10. We're up and ready to go. Surely this round won't be as good as the last one.
This is part of the game plan. You knew this was going to happen. Now you've got to stay still in your mind. You've got to think, right, don't get rattled. Don't get swayed by the crowd cheering or booing. Look straight in there, stick to your game plan, show your shot, and then let it go. But do it at your pace.
We both know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
Might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
This fighter realizes that defense is one of the criteria in boxing. Gets out of where that left hand. This offensive display landing that left counter. Nice job landing with that right hand. Don't let your hands go. Yes, there's a cut, and the referee will stop the action.
You're taking too much, the fight is over.
That will do it. Tough luck here as this fight is over.
This should have been stopped.
So it is a TKO win here. No doubt about the outcome.